Good morning, everyone. Welcome to grade 5 mathematics class. How are you all doing today? We are learning about multiplication of decimals. Today, let's see how we can multiply two decimal numbers. Look at the question given here. Find the product of 2.8 and 3.12. How can we divide these two decimal numbers? To multiply two decimal numbers, there are a few steps involved. Let's see the steps one by one. So the first step is to ignore the decimal points and then take the numbers as 28 and 312, and after that take their product. So you are given two decimal numbers. To multiply the two decimal numbers, you just ignore the decimal points in them and just take their product like whole numbers. So when you multiply 28 and 312, you get the product 8736. Now the next step is to put the decimal point at the correct place. How do we decide where to put the decimal point? To find out where to put the decimal point, you have to count the number of digits after the decimal point in both the multiplier and the multiplicand. So here we have done the multiplication, we got a product. So in 2.8, how many digits are there after the decimal point? There is only one digit. And in 3.12, there are two digits, 1, 2. So you have to add the number of digits in the multiplier and the multiplicand. So here you have one and here you have two digits after the decimal point. Therefore, the total number of digits after the decimal points is 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So we got that there are three digits after the decimal points in total. So count three places from right to left in the product. That would be 1, 2, 3. There you put the decimal point. So the final answer, the final product is 8.736. Product of 2.8 and 3.12 is 8.736. Hope this is clear to you. Now let's see one more question. If 1 liter of petrol costs rupees 68.50, then how much should Jennifer pay for 23 liters of petrol? So what is the cost of 1 liter of petrol? It is rupees 68.50. And what is the cost of 23 liters of petrol in that case? It would be 23 times the cost of 1 liter of petrol, right? So let's see the steps. The cost of 1 liter of petrol is equal to rupees 68.50, and cost of 23 liters of petrol will be cost of 1 liter of petrol into 23. That would be equal to 68.50 into 23. Let's do the multiplication in the working column, which is the broader margin on the right side of your notebook. Let's write the numbers 68.50 into 23. So we are going to multiply a decimal number with a whole number. Let's do the multiplication ignoring the decimal point at the beginning. 3 into 0, 0. 3 into 5, 15. 5 here, carry over 1 to the next place. 3 into 8, 24 plus 1, 25. Carry over 2. 3 into 6, 18 plus 2, 20. Then there is one more digit here, 2 into 0, 0, 2 into 5, 10, a carry over 1, 2 into 8, 16 plus 1, 17, a carry over 1, 2 into 6, 12 plus 1, 13. Then inserting a 0, now adding the products, 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 0, 5, 5 plus 0, 5, 0 plus 7 is 7, 2 plus 3 equal to 5, then 1. So this is the product of the multiplication. Now we have to put the decimal point. So in the decimal number, there are two digits after the decimal point. So count two places from right to left in the final product. So that would be 1, 2. Put the decimal point here. So the cost of 23 liters of petrol is rupees 1575.50. Jennifer should pay 1575.50. Hope this is clear to you. Now children, let's see some properties of decimal multiplication. So when you multiply a whole number by 1, what is the product? The product will be the number itself. Same is the case with decimal numbers. When you multiply a decimal number with 1, the product is the decimal number itself. You can see a couple of examples here. 45.27 into 1. That would be 45.27 itself. Or when you do 1 into 181.9, the product will be 181.9 itself, the number itself. Now, the multiplication with 0. So when you multiply a whole number by 0, the product will always be 0. Same is the case with decimal numbers. The product of a decimal number and 0 is 0. Here you have two examples. 0.392 into 0 will be 0 itself. Now 0 into 38.25 will also be equal to 0. Now let's do one activity. All of you please take your maths notebook. We can write the heading multiplication of two decimals. Then you can take down these questions in your notebook. Pause the video, take down the questions, work them out and come back. Hope you are done with that. Now let's discuss each question one by one. The first one, 3.51 into 7.9. Let's do the multiplication. We are multiplying two decimal numbers. So let's ignore the decimal point in the beginning and we get the numbers 351 into 79. 9 into 1, 9. 9 into 5, 45. Writing 5 here. Carrying forward the 4 to the next place. 9 into 3 is 27 plus 4, get 31. Then the next digit, 7 into 1, 7. 7 into 5, 35. 5 here, 3 carried over to next place. 7 into 3, 21 plus 3, 24. Inserting 0 to correct the columns. Adding the products, we get 9 plus 0, 9. 7 plus 5, 12. Carry over to the next place. 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1, 7. 3 plus 4, 7. Then this 2. Now we have to put the decimal point. So let's count the number of digits after the decimal point in the multiply and the multiplicand. So in the multiplicand you have 1, 2 places and the multiplier you have 1 place. So there is a total of 2 plus 1, 3 places. So count 3 places from right to left. 1, 2, 3. Here you put the decimal point. So the final product is 27.729. I hope you got the answer correct. Now the next one. 5.3 into 6.2. Let's do the multiplication ignoring the decimal point in the beginning. That would be 53 into 62. 3 into 2, 6. 2 into 5, 10. 6 into 3, 18. Carry over. 6 into 5, 30 plus 1, 31. 0 to correct the places. Adding the products, 6 plus 0, 6, 0 plus 8, 8, 1 plus 1, 2, 3 here. Now, one place after the decimal point in the multiplicand as well as the multiplier. So 1 plus 1, 2. So 1, 2. Two places from right to left in the final product. Final answer or the final product is equal to 3.86. I hope you got this one also correct. Now you can go through the topic multiplication of two decimals in page number 91 of your textbook. Go through it once again. Then move on to exercise 5.5. You have to complete the questions 1s to 1x and also the question numbers 4 and 5 which are word problems. So once you are done with that, please move on to the next set of exercise. You have the LS exercise and the Holtz exercise right below exercise 5.5. Go through those questions as well and do accordingly. Once you are done with all these activities, please do take a picture and send us through Teams. So that's all for today, children. We'll meet in the next class with a new topic. Until then, bye.